Hello student, welcome to the KTHM e-learning portal. I am Pratik Shinde, working as an assistant professor in Department of Zoology, KTHM College, Nasik. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the subject Applied Zoology first, and we are going to cover the chapter Sericulture. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about and the topic Silkworm Rearing Appliances. In previous lecture, we already discussed about an silkworm rearing house. But in this lecture, we are going to study silkworm rearing appliances or the silkworm rearing equipments used in sericulture. This equipment help to rear and handling of silkworm for the good yield of a silk. These are the appliances such as rearing stand, rearing tray and wheels, chopping board and chopping knife, feather, chopsticks, leaf chamber, paraffin paper, and last one is mountage or chandrika. These all appliances we will discuss one by one. First, we start with rearing stand. The rearing stands are made up of wood or bamboos and are portable. That's mean this rearing stand we have move one place to another place easily. These are the frames at which rearing trays are kept. A rearing stand should be 2.5 meter in height and 1.5 meter long and the 1 meter width and should have 10 to 12 shelves. The tray are arranged on the slabs and each stand can accommodate 10 rearing trays. This is the picture of rearing stand and these shelves are arranged on the rearing stand. Then the second appliances is rearing trays. Rearing trays are used for rearing silkworm and are placed on a rearing stand. There are many kinds of rearing trays differing from one another in material, shape and size. The rearing stand made from wood and plastics. The traditionally rearing trays are made up of bamboo or wood so that they are light and easy to handle. These are either rounded or rectangular in shape. Nowadays, rectangular plastic trays are widely used in rearing of silkworm. Then, the next appliances is ant wheels. Ant wheels are provided to stop ants from crawling on the trays, as ant as a serious threat to the silkworm. They are made from concrete or stone block or plastic with a deep groove at the center. The legs of a rearing stand rest on the center of the well filled with water or oils. This water and oil stop crawling the ant on the rearing tray and rearing stand. See here, this is a ant well and the leg of rearing stand kept into the center of the ant well. Then the chopping board and chopping knife. The chopping board, it is made from soft wood used for cutting the leaves of mulberry, used for feeding the young silkworms. The chopping knife made from steel or iron. It is used for cutting the mulberry leaves. For the easy to feed to the silkworms. Then the feather. Large white bird feather are important for rearing worms. These are used for brushing newly hatched worm to the prevent injuries. It also helpful while changing the bed. See here, using the feather, the brushing of newly hatched larva into the rearing bed. Then the chopstick. Chopstick are tapering bamboo rods meant used to pick up younger stages of larva to ensure their hygiene, handling and preventing from injuries. See here, the chopstick used to remove off infected larva from the rearing tray. Then the leaf chamber. The leaf should be preserved in a moist, cool and clean place in order to preserve their succulence. The ideal condition for preservation of leaf is below 20 degrees Celsius atmospheric temperature and over 90% of relative humidity. The individual leaf harvest should be collected in a bamboo basket covered with wet gunny cloth and transported to the preservation room. When the leaves are to be stored in bulk quantity, leaf chamber lined with wet gunny cloth are used. Then the paraffin paper. Thick craft paper sheet coated with paraffin wax. The melting point of the paraffin wax is 55 degrees Celsius are required to cover the rearing trays to maintain the humidity in a rearing bed and prevent weathering of chopped leaves. It is used for rearing early stage of silkworm. Main aim of the paraffin paper is to increase the humidity and maintain humidity in a rearing bed. Then the mountage or the chandrika. The most important device that help or support the silkworm for comfortable spinning their cocoon is called as cocoonage or mountage. It determines both quality and quantity of the cocoon. Different type of cocoonage are used in different parts of India. In general, these are the made from wood, bamboo, cardboard, plastic, grass, dry leaves, twigs, etc. These all cocoonage or mountage help to the silkworm for comfortable spinning and increase the yield and quality of cocoon. Chandrika, this is a round or rectangular shape of mountage. It is made from bamboo mat, supported by split bamboo wrappers on all sides. The only difference between mountage and chandrika is the chandrika is made from bamboo strips and its shape is rectangular. That's why this cocoonage is called as chandrika. In this lecture, we have discussed all the appliances or equipment mainly used during the rearing of silkworm. Thank you.